This video is sponsored by Squarespace. If you want an amazing online presence for your business or brand, Squarespace is the all-in-one platform for building websites and online stores, as well as access to marketing tools and analytics. If you've been around here for a while, then you'll know that some of our most popular videos stem from Mike Judge's show, King of the Hill. King of the Hill was a show about changing times and culture wars which benefited from a changing America. So today, we're going to document what we believe is the most accurate order of events for this amazing show. I'm Kyle with Wicked Binge, and this is the King of the Hill timeline. Like our SpongeBob timeline, we had to make a lot of assumptions, and for most of the episodes, we assume the air date is the date the episode takes place, unless we specify otherwise. And something important to note, the air dates are important because many of the trending things featured in each episode come from a certain year, even though our characters stay roughly the same age throughout. It's one of those odd cartoon time frame things that we're just meant to suspend disbelief for. And of course, we're not going to talk about every single episode, but we'll focus on the ones that we think are the most interesting or important to the timeline. We also have official dates for a lot of things, so that makes the first half of the timeline easier. So let's get started with the Roaring Twenties and Great Depression, the 1920s and 30s. Although not much of importance happens during this time, Cotton Hill is born in 1927, his ex-wife, Tilly Garrison, in 1929, and then Buck Strickland in 1931. Besides that, World War II wasn't too far away, and would actually play a key role in the Hill lineage. World War II and after, the 1940s. With the start of World War II, Cotton felt he needed to serve his country, so in 1941, when he was 14, he lied to Uncle Sam and joined the military.
You want to hear that story, fatty?
Sir, yes, sir!
From the years 1943 to 1945, Cotton served with the Allies in the war, and this is where he supposedly killed 50 men. Cotton made a lot of claims about the things he did during the war, ranging from climbing the cliffs of Normandy with an ice cream maker on his back, to being stuck in a Japanese POW camp. He also claimed to crawl through a minefield to get a pipe for his general in 1944. Two official dates also stand out, such as January 30th, 1944, where he led a crew to invade Anzio, which was confirmed by the other veterans. The other one is May 2nd, 1945, which is when Cotton allegedly invented a bayonet technique that the military still uses. Towards the end of his tour, he escaped a Japanese Zero after being stranded in the ocean, fought off sharks, and charged a Japanese machine gun nest before having his shins shot off. Luckily, he was able to survive by beating the Japanese to death with a big piece of his friend, Fatty. After the war ended, Cotton was in a Japanese veterans hospital and met Michiko, and the two started a relationship which led to the birth of Junichiro in December of 1946. Cotton was forced to leave Japan by the military after he got better, and he didn't go back to Japan for a long time. Post-World War II, the 1950s. A quick stop in the 1950s is necessary due to the sheer amount of main characters who were born during this time. Hank, Bill, Boomhauer, and Dale were all born in 1953, Peggy and Nancy being born in 1954, and Con was born in 1957. No other majorly important events seem to happen within this decade to the main characters, but that changes in the following decades. The good old days, the 1960s and 70s. The 60s and 70s were decades where a lot of important events happened. Fan-favorite characters like Min and John Redcorn were born in these years, 1960 and 61 respectively. Not to mention that Lucky was born in 1962, and Dee Dee Hill was officially born in 1966, although later statements contradict this. Another big thing that happened in the 1960s was the Arlen High School Football League, where Hank, Bill, and Boomhauer were prominent players on the team, and Dale was the towel manager. During this time, Bill made a career touchdown record that would later be lost and then tied up, and Hank would cost the team an important game due to his ankle. However, However, the 70s were when things really started to pick up for Hank and the rest. While it's unknown exactly what year, it can be assumed that in 1970 is when Peggy and Hank really started dating. Although it could be earlier, as no official date exists. The following year, in 1971, Hank and Bill would both apply for the military, and while Bill would be accepted, Hank was denied thanks to his narrow urethra. It's also unknown exactly when, but somewhere between 1970 and 1975, Khan spent 2 years in the killing fields in Cambodia during the Laotian Civil War. The following events also don't have official dates, but based on statements, we can place them in the late 70s, specifically around 1977 or later. Firstly, according to the episode It's Not Easy Being Green, Bill, Dale, and Hank left Boomhauer's car in the quarry, which flooded, and left his prestigious Sally missing for 20 years.
Hank committed this tragedy all alone.
Also during this time frame, Bill protects Hank in a bar, and this causes Hank to get a tattoo of Bill's name on the back of his head. According to the father, the son, and JC, Hank has been assistant manager of Strickland Propane for 20 years, which would place that in this time zone. On a side note, Buckley was born in 1978, and Luann is a year younger, having been born in 1979. The next generation, the 1980s. The 80s is another decade where not a lot happens outside of a few main characters being born. Firstly, in 1982, Lady Bird, the family dog, is born. Also in the year 1982 is allegedly when Dale and Nancy get married. While it's not a very good marriage, as merely a year later is when Nancy starts cheating on him with John Redcorn, they do stay together for quite a long time. Also, it's worth mentioning that from the year 1982 to 1984 is when Bill started getting shots for the government's Project Walrus, although it's unknown how true this government project is. The autumn of 1985 is when all three of the main child/teen characters are born. August is when Bobby was born, as he is the oldest. Joseph follows suit in September, and Connie is born in the month of November. Finally, prior to the start of the show, according to a visual joke in The Exterminator, Dale's dead bug seems to have started in the year 1987. This can be assumed thanks to the fact that Dale won Employee of the Year from 1987 to 2000, save for 1996, where Rusty Shackelford won the award. According to everything we can find, King of the Hill officially starts in 1997, the same year that it aired. But before we get into the next section, I first want to take a minute to talk about today's sponsor, Squarespace. The more that we expand our network of YouTube channels, the more I realize the importance of having a strong and professional online presence. Squarespace provides all the tools you need as a YouTuber, a business owner, or a content creator to build amazing websites and online stores. Squarespace is user-friendly enough for someone like me who isn't a professional when it comes to website building, because I can still make incredibly slick and professional sites for my brand, which is why it's easily my favorite service out there. I've been using Squarespace to put together a new site for our channels, and not only have I been having a lot of fun doing it, I'm really happy with how it's coming out. As a YouTuber, I can easily present and organize my videos on my own website, and it doesn't require me to be a coding expert. You can connect with your audience, put together members-only content, send email communications, and utilize audience insights. All on one platform. Head over to squarespace.com for a free trial, and when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/wickedbinge and you'll save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. Link in the description. Now let's get back to the video. The first season takes place in the first half of 1997, as far as we can tell. February 9th, 1997, Hank meets Willie Nelson, his personal hero, after Bobby accidentally throws a baseball bat at his head. March 2nd, 1997, the Supanusenpone family moved into Arlen and became a heavy fixture on Rainy Street. April 13th, 1997, Peggy becomes a Boggle champion after going through a long tournament. October 31st, 1997, the infamous Junie Harper incident, where one lady successfully bans Halloween for a brief period of time by framing Halloween as a Satanist holiday. November 2nd, 1997. Hank accidentally started using drugs to try and catch bass in the water and almost went to prison over it. 1998 had a few very interesting things happen to the cast of Rainy Street. On January 11th, 1998, Luann creates the manger babies from a bunch of puppets she found at a yard sale. April 19th, 1998, Luann's mother, Leanne, reappears at the Hill House and starts a relationship with Bill before being sent away again. May 3rd, 1998, Bobby gets a job at the Arlen Speedway and is abused by his boss. May 17th, 1998 is the most major event in this year, as this is when the Megalomart explodes due to a propane leak and Buckley dies because of it. October 6th, 1998, Peggy finds out about Nancy and John Redcorn's affair and initially wishes to tell Dale. 1999 is the year before Y2K, and a variety of fun things happen in King of the Hill, including some new characters being introduced. On January 12, 1999, and the following days, Dale, Hank, Bill, and Boomhauer all become volunteer firefighters and accidentally help cause the fire station being burnt down and dropping the casket of a recently deceased volunteer. January 19, 1999, Peggy spanks Stuart Dooley after she reaches a breaking point regarding his behavior and gets fired at first, but gets justice and comes back. February 2nd, 1999, Khan gets a new job in Houston after telling Hank company secrets. April 20th, 1999, Pastor Karen Stroop came to Arlen and Cotton almost got imprisoned after a string of events that Bobby caused. April 27th, 1999, Peggy gets tricked by a prisoner to bring in drugs to the prison through the usage of a boggle hourglass. May 4th, 1999, Buckley's Angel comes back down to Earth to lead Luann into joining a junior community college. September 26, 1999. Peggy breaks all of her bones going skydiving due to the information of Cotton's son, G.H.
All right, I'll call him G.H. Good hat.
October 3rd, 1999. Cotton helps Peggy with her physical therapy by generally torturing her into walking. October 24th, 1999. Ricky Shuggs breaks Bill's all-time touchdown record, but Bill rejoins the team and ties up the record again. October 31st, 1999. Peggy earns her third Substitute Teacher of the Year award after pushing Hank out of the running for that award. November 14th, 1999. The Hills are invited to New Orleans for a football game, and Don Meredith fails to sink the football into the hull of the can, meaning Hank earns no money.
Tough break, son.
December 19th, 1999. Hank steals propane in preparation for Y2K, and he goes crazy with fear regarding Y2K, thanks to Dale, but he makes up for it by buying a computer for his wife. The Middle Years, Seasons 4 to 10, 2000 to 2005. The year 2000 starts off the middle years of the series, which have a lot of interesting episodes that change the series heavily. February 6, 2000. Debbie, one of the employees of Strickland Propane, commits accidental suicide while trying to kill and/or seduce Bug Strickland. February 27, 2000. Luann finally moved out of the den at the Hill House and instead moved into the house across the street from them. On or around April 14, 2000, it turns out that Bobby may be the reincarnation of Llama St. Glug. April 30th, 2000. Nancy ends up breaking off her long-standing relationship with John Redcorn. May 21st, 2000. Peggy assaults and almost drowns Randy Travis for stealing her song. November 7th of this year is also when Hank and Luann both vote in the 2000 presidential election after Hank has issues with George W. Bush's handshake.
It was soft and damp. Let's just leave it at that.
December 17th of 2000. Bill started up a Christmas village on his lawn, but it goes on at least until January 15th of 2001, since they mention Martin Luther King Jr. Day. On February 25th, 2001, Hank accidentally becomes a pimp for a woman named Tammy and has to chase another pimp out of Arlen. March 4th, 2001. Dale has to give up the toxins he uses to kill bugs or it will kill him. So he gets another job at Stick Tech, but he soon goes back to exterminating afterwards. A few days later, on March 11th, 2001, Luann becomes a born-again virgin and almost marries Rhett Vandergraff. April 1st, 2001, Hank builds a doghouse for Ladybird due to Bobby's dander allergy. April 22nd, 2001, Dale sues his cigarette company so that he can pay for his wife's facelift, getting a countersue by the company instead of making money. May 6th, 2001, Hank finds out he has diminished gluteal syndrome, causing him to wear a fake butt, and dealing with those issues during the Durndal County Mower Race. Jumping forward to November 11th, 2001, Bobby takes his self-defense class that tells him to kick people in the groin. December 9th, 2001, Dale runs for his fourth term as gun club president and has to deal with his opponent Mad Dog's insanity. December 12th, 2001, Peggy accidentally kidnaps a young girl named Lupe from Mexico and ultimately isn't put in jail due to her poor Spanish comprehension. On December 16th and the following days of 2001, Hank starts building a Habitat for Humanity for Buck Strickland and says that he loves him, causing Cotton to hate him, and Jimmy Carter has to bring the two men back together as father and son.
I see a new era of trust and understanding between you.
Heading into 2002, we find a lot of very important changes happening to the cast of Rainy Street. January 6, 2002 is when Connie and Bobby break up but decide to continue staying friends. February 14th of 2002 is when Bill convinces Bobby that he will never find another person to love, causing him to try and get back together with Connie. On February 24th of that year, Hank is signed up by Dale, Bill, and Boomhauer to be the person to run the 2002 Winter Olympic torch across Ireland, but the flame falls in a puddle and snuffs out. March 17th, 2002, Peggy impersonates a nun in an attempt to get more full-time work. On March 31st, Bill steals the tank when he finds out about Project Walrus, riding it through Rainy Street. On April 14th, Peggy uncovers a conspiracy to sell tainted beer to Mexico and causes mass food poisoning among a group of higher-ups. April 21st, 2002, Luann accidentally joined a cult on her college campus. A week later, on April 28th, Nancy and Dale renew their vows and find out that Dale's dad is gay and didn't kiss Nancy on purpose on their wedding day.
I loved my dad like a father.
May 12th, 2002, Cotton and the rest of the Hill family climb on a plane and fly to Japan. They meet Junichiro and his mother, and Hank shows Junichiro many American tendencies by the time they leave. And by that time, Junichiro has grown to not hate his dad. On June 5th, 2002, Topsy Toppington, one of Cotton's war buddies, dies. November 17th. Bobby is tricked into creating a meth lab by Connie's cousin, Tid Pau. December 15th, 2002. This is when Hank accidentally cuts off Dale's finger with a skill saw and has to go to anger management. He eventually saves Dale's life from a garbage truck crushing him. January 12th, 2003, Dale is hired by the Megalomart for a rat infestation that turns out to be Chuck Mangione. February 2nd, Luann started a boxing career thanks to Buck Strickland, who was rigging the fights. On February 9th, 2003, Hank and Dale try to invoke a vision quest in Joseph, but Dale gets one instead that makes him believe he is a Native American. March 2nd, 2003, Min, Nancy, and Peggy all try to run for the school board, but fail thanks to all of them sabotaging each other. March 16th, 2003. Bobby briefly became a salesman for Strickland Propane, breaking Hank's selling record in a short time, but he brought a large amount of bad press by failing to have any knowledge of propane. On March 30th, Buck loses the deed to North Strickland Propane in a poker game and joins Luann's Bible study class before trying to marry her. May 18th, 2003. Khan's mother comes to Arlen and starts dating Bill, and Khan tries to destroy the relationship. In the days leading up to and including October 31st, 2003, Trip Larson, a sausage mogul, starts dating Luann and tries turning her into a reincarnation of a lady from an advertisement, and he then dies a gruesome death.
Trip had a mental breakdown and is now a sausage.
November 2nd, 2003. Boomhauer's brother Patch comes to Arlen and gets married, even though he's shown to be quite a scumbag. The marriage is eventually called off. November 16th, 2003. Former cowboy player Willie Lane moves to Arlen but has to leave because Hank threatens an assault charge on him. November 30th, 2003. Eduardo Felipe, a Mexican actor, hires Peggy thanks to her teaching skills, but Peggy thinks he's hitting on her, causing her to go home depressed. December 14th, 2003. Hank, alongside Bobby, Dale, Bill, and Boomhauer, bring Tilly, her dead friend's, furniture for Christmas. Moving into 2004, on January 4th, Bobby believes that Hank is a lot richer than he actually is, starting to spend a lot of money from Hank's account, causing a lot of trouble for the Hills. February 15th, 2004. Luann drops out of junior college just so she can go back to her haircutting dreams, eventually getting hired by Hank's barber. March 21st, 2004. Storms hit Arlen and the dam bursts, causing a massive flood that gives Bill too much power, locking Hank up when he gets back to the safe house, because they thought he caused the flood. May 16th, 2004. Connie gets denied from a summer school for being just another bright Asian girl, causing Khan to break down and become his own boss, and become more similar to the rednecks he always made fun of.
I got a new boss and I love him. Me!
On November 7th, Peggy goes back to her family ranch and deals with Henry Winkler, having started to destroy the farm's supply line, but even though she saves the ranch, she is not thanked. December 19th, 2004. An old woman named Miss Wakefield wants to die in Hank's house, and he denies her, which causes a lot of blowback from others. Moving into 2005, on January 30th, Dale rereads the Warren Commission report and realizes that the US government may have been correct about JFK's murder, causing him to become a big fan of the government for a change. On March 30th, 2005, Luann starts dating Lucky, and Lucky tears up a football field after a set of events regarding an egomaniacal caretaker. April 10th, 2005. John Redcorn opens up a casino and eventually a child-friendly native village on his land. On April 17th, Dale becomes the smoking bandit by going into locations and smoking to annoy the owners by disobeying their no-smoking ordinances and causing Joseph to look up to him. May 1st, 2005. Nancy moves up from being a weather girl and becomes co-anchor on the news after a wildfire. May 15th, Bill goes AWOL from the army when he joins an all-male chorus group, thinking no one would notice he was gone. On September 25th, Peggy tells people to mix ammonia and bleach, which makes a poisonous gas after she stops stealing ideas from men. November 6, 2005, Bill makes his home into a halfway house for a short time to have more people around him.
We're working on taking emotional risks.
The show ends. Season 10 to 13, 2006 to 2008. That said, 2006 is by far the most packed year in the series. The reason why 2006 is so packed is because we find out in the season 10 finale, edumacating Lucky, that Luann is pregnant. And it turns out that Luann is pregnant for 3 seasons until season 13, specifically the episode Lucky See Monkey Do, which would make her pregnant for several years. This is just another example of that cartoon timeline logic, in which we suspend disbelief. In 2006, we have 3-ish seasons of content to wade through, so we need to make a lot of assumptions. January 29th, 2006, Hank's softball team, the Zephyrs, become undefeated and decide to go up against another undefeated gimmick team called the Ace of Diamonds and his Jewels. They lose 63-1. March 9th, 2006, Bobby shadows a man named Peter Sterling who cleans up animal waste and has a good time doing it. Hank is surprised at how profitable his business is, and Bobby starts up a vomit cleaning service, but Hank shuts it down by staging the assault of Peter. April 9th, 2006. The Hill family's church pew is stolen, so Hank and the rest go to a megachurch. But they tell Karen Stroop that they would tell everyone about the megachurch if they didn't get their seat back, which they do. April 30th, 2006. Joseph and Bobby quit their arrow spinning job so they can panhandle. Bobby eventually gets a real job, and Hank tells people not to give the panhandling teens any money. May 14th. Lucky fails to get his GED, thanks to Peggy, so he could marry Luann. They have a shotgun wedding afterwards. This is also when we find out that Luann is pregnant. In the summer of 2006, Lucky gives Bobby a large serpent named Josh that escapes into the sewers, and Dale and Hank need to go catch it since the snake catchers were tricking people. Also in the summer of 2006, Peggy fakes her death to get out of a contract with Cozy Kitchens. Not long after, Lucky and Luann get married after a convoluted plan from Lucky's lawyer to sue Strickland Propane after slipping and falling over while working for Dale's dead bug.
If you want to play hardball, we could probably take Gribble's house.
October 7th, 2006. Bobby becomes a member of the Powderpuff Girls at Tom Landry Middle School. On November 11th, 2006, Cotton Hill dies after slipping on a hibachi grill and getting severely burned. On November 18th, Hank buys tough steaks from the Megalomart, so instead he goes to the local co-op because they were farm to table. On November 9th, 1906, Min and Khan finally get to join the Ten Rivers Country Club thanks to Min's skeet shooting prowess. In late 2006, Lady Bird gets so old that she goes deaf and bites Hank on the hand. Also in late 2006, the Arlen City Council bans trans fats for a short amount of time. Luann's father Hoyt comes to Arlen with only one strike left from having life in prison. Hoyt ends up sending Lucky to jail, but is forced by Hank to admit to his crimes.
Hank, don't tell Luann it went down like this.
In early 2007, Ted Wasanasan buys up Bill's neighbor's house and tries to turn it into a McMansion. Also in early 2007, Buck Strickland makes a MySpace page for Strickland Propane, but it gets taken over by a fired individual, and she is ultimately rehired and changes it back to normal. February 8th, 2007, Gracie is born after three seasons of Luann being pregnant. February 15th, 2007, Buck meets his long-lost son, Ray Roy, and the two get drunk and almost cost Buck his induction into the Propane Hall of Fame. By the end of the episode, both Buck and Hank are inducted into the Propane Hall of Fame. On March 8th, 2007, Bill accidentally breaks Hank's nose during football practice, but Hank comes back and still wins the game. On May 10th, 2007, John Redcorn and Luann make a multitude of direct-to-DVD videos of the Manger Babies. In the summer of 2007, Boomhauer switches houses with a Canadian family who seemed to despise America and Texas and got in the group's crosshairs. Hank, however, still helps the Canadian neighbor out of jail, but he doesn't appreciate it. On the 4th of July, Rainy Street goes to war, while Bobby becomes a born-again Christian. On September 13th, 2007, Bobby joins a meat inspection team, and while the team doesn't like him, he manages to win the competition. Bobby and Hank have a barbecue that the whole neighborhood enjoys, and the show ends in a similar way to how it started. In March of 2008, a year after the events of Bois My Nose, Hank and the rest go to the next town over and make fun of the football captain for being a loser.
Happy loser-versary!
Logically, since those events of the episode take place in 2007, from what we can tell, we can logically place these events in 2008. And with that said, the end of King of the Hill is here. We had to make a lot of assumptions as we hit the end of the series. So tell us in the comment section below, what was your favorite era of King of the Hill? Make sure to hit that notification bell and binge more of our King of the Hill videos, including our King of the Hill characters Good to Evil. And tell us what cartoon needs the timeline treatment next. But most importantly, stay wicked.